Assalamualaikum guys. So today we will enter the new chapter, energy data analysis. So we will start with the introduction and what energy consumption, normalized performance, time dependence energy analysis, linear regression analysis, and Kusum. Most probably we will try to cover half of this slide, and yet for the next following weeks we will try to complete this chapter. So basically, an introduction, energy data can be collected through audit and continuous monitoring. So that's the beauty of having the energy management, because if you mention about the energy management, so you need to have the data for you guys to monitor and yet to investigate whichever current situation or abnormality happen throughout your organization. Okay. Energy data needs to be analyzed, of course, and interpreted. So normally, the level of the engineer or maybe the person or the person in charge at a particular line of operation can be able to interpret easily compared to the person who are not in the production line or in the operation line. Okay? So because they are the one who use all the energy, so that they can easily determine what is the possible cost due to the increment or decrement of the energy usage at that particular division or department or organization. Okay, so trend of consumption can be predicted, of course, and improvement of supply can be made or adjusted. So yet, all the energy management will firmly according to the data or input from the monitoring. So that's why it is very crucial to have some sort of data collection. Okay, and then maybe in the data collection, they go for the very raw data. So you guys as an engineer will do the analysis and then maybe the pattern, the trend, just to predict or estimate what's the behavior of your energy consumption in your particular organization. Okay? And yet you can go for the very statistical and numerical analysis. You can go for the very simple calculation and also go for your complex equation or simulation or something. So it depends. But the main important, it should present something based on your reliable data. Okay, so that's the crucial. Okay, so annual energy consumption, it can be a simplest way of analysis. Percentage breakdown for annual energy consumption, annual cost data, useful technique for overall energy performance, easy to be assessed. So by having this kind of report, we can conclude as a part of the justification to be replaced the equipment or maybe need to invest the another equipment. So based on this report, guys, so you need to be very careful to get the reliable data so that it will be demonstrate the real actual condition of your utilization of your energy so that you can propose a good recommendation based on your data collection. Or else, if your data is not convincing or not reliable, so you may go for the wrong justification or wrong prediction or estimation, yet release to the not worth investment to solve the problem occur. Okay. So this is a very, very sick and quick forward method. Convert all energy consumption into standard using data conversion factor. Okay, maybe in your machine or your equipment in the form of MJ, a megajoule or gigajoule, try to make it in the form of this standard or uniform unit, which is kilowatt hour, so that you can do the comparison easily by looking for the same unit. Okay, so this is the another unit of the energy that we can convert it into the kilowatt hour, okay. Electricity, natural gas. Okay. So this is the unit. So bear in your mind, you should compare those energy by using the similar unit so that you can have a better or clear picture what's the fluctuation due to that particular usage, because you are referring to the same unit instead of different unit, which is released to the different, maybe the different length or different usage or different range of the utilization. Okay, so method produce percentage breakdown of total consumer of very unit average unit cost. Compile the table showing the total energy consumption cost percentage breakdown for each fuel type. First pie chart table historical data. So this another method how you try to show your data. You can go for, let's say, for monthly basis. You can go for yearly basis, okay, and then see the pattern how it goes. Maybe during the first month of year 2020, low production due to the COVID and everything, right? So the company shut down everything, or the worker wanted to come to work or work from home. So, and then after the next following 6 months, it's slightly increased. The pattern is slightly increased. So that's the thing you need to demonstrate to mention to your organization, so that and the best part, you able to justify why the trend happened. Okay, so that based on your maybe the management decision or maybe the global issue due to the environmental concern. Okay, due to the COVID, so people asked to be MCO again, okay? Control order. So that's why most of the electricity consumption relatively low due to the restriction of the operation as well. Okay? So that's the thing. You can go for the bar chart, pie chart, whichever chart that you think might be easily to be understand, okay, by your top management or your by immediate superior. Okay. Also, this is the sample of the graph you can produce. Okay. Normally, they will go for years line for this line graph. So this one is over years. Okay. So it's maybe the consumption. Okay. In the form of the EPU or something. So this one is by the sector. Okay. Maybe you want to try to classify each sector. Okay. You can go as well as this one. This one by the pie chart with the allocation of the usage. With the percentage, and this one is the over the years, the overall power source into the natural gas, renewable energy, and coal. So it not necessarily to have one or two type of graph. It depends how do you want to portray your result. Okay, so you during that at that time as an engineer need to be careful to choose which one is the most representing the current scenario or condition, so that it will be give a good interpretation by the top management, so that by having the information, they can decide what is the next action to be taken to solve the problem or issue. Okay, so another approach, comparison, maybe before and after, maybe before improvement or after improvement, okay, or maybe last year and this year. You can do also the comparison by the type of the equipment or utilization. Okay, so it's depend how detailed you want to be. Okay, so this is the example for household and end users, fuel type and appliances. Okay, so you may go for your own. Let's say for our house, maybe we can put the let's say air conditioning system. Our aircon. Okay? Maybe our aircon this year how much, and then for the last year how much. Then we can compare. So that is the one approach. Or as if you want to go to detail, air conditioning system at the living room, compare from last year and to this year, and then air conditioning room in the bedroom. So we can try to tabulate accordingly based on the thing that what we want to investigate. Okay, if you think that the conditioning system is relatively high in your house, so you may go in detail for that particular comparison or data analysis, so that you can trigger the pattern or the issue why it happened or why it become like that pattern. Okay, so that's the approach. Okay, so this is the another style of demonstrating your result. Okay, so by having the group of the sources, and then go for this kind of sector, and then they try to make a line for each dedicated line or each dedicated sector, so that they can know which one is most contributed for the usage of the energy, okay, for the supply source. Okay, so you also can use the Excel, okay, and produce all the result that we used just now. Also use the Minitab. Minitab is the you are creating the equation on the Minitab, and yet you just inserting the data, and finally they will produce the graph which you have been set previously to become a good graph. Okay, this one is the SPSS, statistical process. It's more related to the big data, which related to the statistical analysis. Okay, statistical analysis. Okay, normalized performance indicator. A good indication of energy performance of a building can be made by comparing it with building with similar type and function. So the idea of having the normalized performance indicator, we need to compare with the same thing. Can they say you want to go for your comparing the what? Comparing the air conditioning utilization. Okay? So you need to refer the same type of building, perhaps, right? Let's say, for example, you try to compare office building with the library, which is not same at all. So it might lead to the not fair comparison, yet will give you none of the idea how do you want to trigger either this one is a good or worsen or better due to the comparison, because it cannot be used as your baseline or benchmark to claim either you are doing the or you are expending high utilization or lower consumption because you are not referring with the same kind of condition. So barrier, okay, so barrier means that the challenges are the building may be also different size, okay, of course. The location, different climate, the building experience different level of exposure. So the building operate different hours. So that's the challenge. Is meaning that it's very hard to get the it's a very challenge to get the very identical building. Okay, very identical building. So that's the maybe another factor why you will get not accurate as the for the result because due to this kind of different due to this kind of concern different size in other words, let's say you are comparing library, okay, library and another library, same library, okay, have occupied everything, but of course the library have the different size, okay, or maybe location different climate, maybe we can consider that as well, because maybe during the raining session, so maybe it's a lower, you know, lower approach of using the conditioning system. Building experience, different level of exposure, of course, that kind of library, maybe surrounding more windows or glass window compared to the other building. They were with the brick wall, so it give the different experience. Okay, of exposure, and also building operate different hours, meaning that maybe one of the library operates only the office time 8 to 5 perhaps, and another library operate maybe 24 hours, so it will give you the deviation of conclude the result based on the same even with the same type of library. Normalized performance indicator, and then 3 to correct construction data, NPI is to address this problem, enable comparison of energy performance, similar type of function, enable overall energy performance to be compared to the standard. Okay, so this is yardstick, okay, are determined by statistical analysis. The provide a useful guide against the building can be measured, usually code in the kilowatt hour per meter square or flow area, or kilowatt hour per meter cube or burning volume per annum. Annual means that per year, okay, per year. Okay, per year. So That's the another instrument how we can use this this data or this report or this analysis to give us some sort of idea what happened in terms of the energy consumption or the energy utilization in our organization. Okay, they are designed to provide useful guidance when established priorities should not be taken as a absolute value to be achieved. The actual potential for improving energy performance is to undertake energy survey intended to allow comparison to be made between similar type of building, either school or with the school. Okay, so let's mention just now, you need to compare with the same type of building. Okay, let's say you are going for school, so we are referring to the school, so we need to consider on that. Right? Okay. So far, any question? Okay, so proceed. So this the since Sir mentioned just now related to the normalized performance indicator. So this the purpose of the building type, which is school, hospital, okay, office, everything, sports center, with pool, with no pool, okay, proportion of fuel use for space heating and hot water attribution of space heating to attributable to space heating. Okay, so this is the thing. So meaning that what they are trying to say, every type of building have their own dedicated percentage of usage. So that we need to consider that because they say you are not been allowed to compare school, for example, with the what with hotel 60, they're different. Obviously different. You may compare from one school to another school. Okay. So that's the concern of it. So from this one, we can see that a church using high space heating and hot water. Not sure, yeah. Factory, also high. 80. School, also high. Okay. Office, sports center, everything. Okay. So this is the sample. Sample to show that every single particular type of building have their own dedicated utilization of energy. Okay. So weather coefficient. The standard annual heating degree days divide by annual heating degree days by building. So this one is very straightforward. Okay. So sheltered, normal, and exposed. Okay. So this is the only equation that we need to consider to get the normalized of the performance. Okay. Hours of the use coefficient, standard annual hours of use, actual annual hours of use. Okay. So this is another skill to determine the normalized performance indicator. For example, nursery, the fair performance range means that 370 over 430. Meaning that if you have the nursery and you fall in this range of the fair performance range, meaning that you are in a good range of utilization. That's the mean of this kind of figure. Let's say you meet, let's say less than this, let's say you go for 200 instead of 370, right? So meaning that you are under utilization, which is maybe you are good enough in saving your energy during your operation. Okay? But normally it will go something that need to be looking at because they already calculated with the good practice in the range of 370 to 430. Meaning that during your nursery, maybe you can achieve less than 370, but perhaps maybe you do not switch on the light, which is you need to switch on your light, kind of. Okay, so you need to ensure that. For example, let's say for restaurant, okay, restaurant, or maybe the okay, restaurant, go for a restaurant. So 410 and 430, meaning that if you fall, if your restaurant fall in this kind of utilization, it's still acceptable. It's a part of the energy management, good energy management. But if you are far beyond this one, maybe you have the excessive utilization of the electricity. Maybe you have Your restaurant is too cold, which is you are should be set in the range of 33 degrees C until 35 degrees C, but yet you go for, let's say, 18 degrees C, for example. So that your utilization slightly higher and yet will exceed the range of the recommended utilization kilowatt hour per meter square. Okay. So that's the idea of having this one. So just imagine this one, fast food outlet, let's say the McD, KFC, everything. Okay, that is one of the sample. So they might go for a very high range of kilowatt hour per meter square. Maybe this due to the, they have also the kitchen inside there. They have the, also the heater, everything inside there. They have also the air conditioning inside there. So by compromise all those facility, it might lead to the range of higher performance. But yet, if the utilization fall until in this range, it should be considerably a good energy management. But yet, if you exceed this range, so maybe some of the element you go for over consume the utilization. Okay, so this is the rest. So this is the rest. Okay, do you think what is the suitable? Suitable number for lecture office or office office ada tak? Can we go to the office? Office, 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 office. Do you think what's the lecture office? What is the fair performance range for lecture office or office standard office? Okay. What range do you think? Anyone can try? Same as what, Zaidi. Same as what? Like Nazmi. Oh, like Nazmi. What is the Nazmi answer? Try to check. Like Nazmi, same. 500 to 700. Okay, 500 to 700. Okay, we will try to check from the table. 500 to 700, 500 to 700, 500 to 700. It should be not that 500 to 700 lah, Nazmi, right? Because more or less like the restaurant connection, right? So maybe we can go lower than that. So maybe we can try to look after. Kita, small office university. Itu, this one? 3 something, 300. Or maybe we can go for the office or something. Small office something lebih natural. If we go for the university, they will go for the 300, 325 until 355, Nazmi. Okay, so that's meaning that every dedicated building have their own dedicated utilization or consumption, utilization of energy, which is allowable in the range of what. So we need to know that one basically so that we know and we claim that we in the range of good practice, or else maybe we waste our energy with unnecessarily usage, which leads to the high of overhead costs. Okay, good try, everybody. Okay, time dependent energy analysis are possible to identify general trend and seasonal pattern in energy consumption. Exception to norm can be identified quickly to be used as comparative tool. Okay, so this is the another way. So previously we just go for the normalized yeah, to compare with the same type of building with the graph, comparison graph, okay, by the time line chart, historical chart, also a historical bar graph, a pie chart, and everything. But this time around, we will go for the time dependent. Means that it relates to the time. Okay, so this is the thing. Time dependent energy analysis. Okay, over the years, meaning that the time, okay, and also the consumption, okay, the fluctuation of the consumption. We can overlap that one, having the thing related to the project. Okay, so maybe you can put another 2010, what it's look like, 2020, what it's look like, with the same period of time. Okay, so that's the time dependent energy analysis. So maybe we, as a good, if you are good enough engineer, we can determine why this kind of range, this one, from this part, okay, from this part. Hold on. From this part, okay, or low, and this part, high. It should be something happen, right? Why it can become here or what it can become here. Oh, okay. So it should be something happen. So we, as if you are is a good engineer, with this kind of data, we should be able to mention the reason why this kind of pattern happen, so that we can conclude. All the things happen maybe with the plan from the management, so that it's not suddenly happen due to the no reason. Okay, so please bear in your mind, guys, to be a good engineer for your future. So up to your level, you should know why this kind of pattern happen. It's not necessarily for this graph, I mean for the energy consumption, anything related to your department or organization which is in your consideration of responsibility. So you need to know to interpret or to justify why this kind of pattern happen, to ensure that you are very clear what happened in your organization or in your department, especially who are in charge for that particular section. Okay, so this is another thing. They do the line graph and as well the chart, okay, and the chart, this bar chart. So they try to combine everything. Okay, still with the same order, this time the vertical for the left hand side is the consumption, and then the left or right hand side is the degree of days. So maybe we can do this one as well. Okay, so depends. Okay, so this is the another way. Figure this one, okay. By the time as well, time dependent. By the time. But the vertical can be changes. Okay. Depends what is the thing you want to investigate. And yet you can put numbers of parameter. For example, so I have fuel economy, mileage, fuel consumption. So that make your graph more understandable, and yet you can conclude something from your graph. Okay. Next, linear regression analysis. Linear regression analysis is something that a statistical technique which determine and quantify the relationship between the variable. Okay. Widely used energy and measurement tool which enables standard equation established for energy consumption, often from data which otherwise be meaningless. Okay, so that's the things. Okay. Time dependent analysis has a limitation, difficulty to identify which certain trend occur. Okay. So the start panic button of the time dependent analysis is that the graph is something that never been happened before, which is you also don't know what is the cause of the thing, which is need further investigation to conclude why the behavior of the pattern happened. Okay. But since normally if you are in charging your parts or your section, you're already familiar or you can experience on the particular department. So I think there should be no problem for you guys to determine whichever condition of your graph due to your expert or your experience on that particular revision or department. Okay. So, or audit perceived trend actually exists at all. Okay. So, linear regression analysis, remove the time element from analysis, focusing the variable which influence energy consumption. It's a versatile technique which can be used to analyze a wide variety of applications. Okay. Linear regression analysis. Okay, so this is another method for the analysis. Okay, we call this a linear regression. Meaning that we can use the existing data to predict the future data of future condition. Let's say the pattern, for example, let's say the pattern we already developed the graph. Let's say we have the positive slope of linear equation, but with a certain limitation of years, let's say 2020. So by having the information from the existing graph, we able to have the prediction or estimate by extending the existing condition referring to the slope of the graph. Okay, so that's why there is the forecast that we call this forecast based on the previous historical data, which they are trying to do based on the data collection previously. Okay. It should therefore be treated with care if analysis indicate the absence of significant relationship between variable does not necessarily mean that no relationship exists. The significant result depends on the quantity and quality. Okay. The significant result depends on the quantity and quality of the data used and indeed on the variable used. Okay. So electricity, outside security lighting, water, gas, electricity, oil, electricity as well, diesel, steam. So normally, this is the activity related to this kind of commodity, outside security lighting, okay, everything, yeah. Gas, electricity, steam racing of thermal plant, air compressor. So those things. The possible factor, hours of darkness, number of data, heating degree days. So this is the possible factor that you require to perform the task with using of this kind of commodity. Okay. For example, heating degree days. Okay. Okay, so you need to specify and you need the gas to fill up your specific works or operation. Single dependence variable, this relationship is in fact linear. It can be derived using equation for the best fit straight line curve throughout the point plotted on the graph. Okay, so the best fit straight line curve is determined by summing the square of the distance from the straight line of the various data point. Okay. When established, this linear equation can be used to predict future energy consumption. So this is the thing that Sir mentioned just now. So by having this kind of graph or the like linear equation, sorry, so you can use that governing equation or like equation to predict the future energy consumption. In addition, it can be used as a method, a standard performance equation for energy monitoring and targeting purposes. So that's why, as I mentioned just now, it's very crucial to have the data monitoring, data collection, because it's not only for your monitoring, you know, task for monitoring your condition of your operational, but yet it also can be used is as a tool to predict or estimate maybe the energy consumption for the future. Okay, for example, you can extend the equation maybe for the another months, few months, or maybe another years, so that you can prepare according to the response of the equation. Response for the prediction that you've been targeted. Yet you also can set your target by having the better forecasting due to the good linear equation. Okay, so it's a crucial to have the data for you guys as an engineer to do this kind of work. Yet, if you don't have this kind of data, it's a problem for you guys to trigger the problem, okay? To set the target, or maybe you set the target without any baseline or references. You just put the target, but you do not need you don't know what is the current situation which is you need to achieve for your target. Okay, so that's the question. And yet, it's the difficult. Yes, you cannot have a baseline or references to do estimation or forecast, because you do not have the previous data to assist you to make a good judgment in terms of the forecasting. So this is the single independent variable. Y, Mx plus C, seems like the linear equation, right? Linear equation, straight line equation. Y, Mx plus C, which is the C is the intersection at the y-axis. M is the slope of the graph, straight line. X is the horizontal axis. Okay. So this is the equation. So this is the sample. Okay. N, this one is N. Refer to this N. Okay. 12N. X, Y, X power of 2, meaning that this X power of 2, 72 times 72. X, Y means that X minus X times Y. So 72 times 482, it can become this one. And yet, 2508 is the summation of the X value. 9948 is the summation of the Y, everything. 635280 is the summation of the X power of 2. And 2340830 is the summation of the XY, X times Y, okay, all this thing. And yet, after that, just insert and using this equation, since you have unknown for C and M, but you have the two equation, so meaning that you can solve this equation, okay, for N, okay, 12, summation of X, 2508, summation of Y, 9948, summation of X, you can use this one, same, summation of X2, 635280, and the summation of XY, 2340830, okay, so, and then, solve this equation. More or less, you get this kind of information or result. 12C plus 2508 and 429408. Okay, so by having the simultaneous solution, you can get C, this is the interception, this is the slope, 2.3, and Y, 2.354X plus 336.73. Okay, so any question regarding to the this single independent variable? Anyone, guys? Yeah, no. So proceed then. Okay, no, thank you. Okay, Zahid, thank you. Azmi, thank you. Okay, so proceed. Okay, sample linear regression example 2. So you wish to examine the linear dependency of the annual sales of produce store on their size in square footage, okay. Sample data for 7 store were obtained. So meaning that this is 7 store. Okay, so find the equation of the straight line, the fit the data best. So If you consider the store is the end, okay, store is the end. So the X is the square feet, and the Y is the annual sales. Then you can try to solve this equation, this question by referring this kind of solution. Right? This solution. So yet, but guys, can you share with sir, how do you determine which one is the x-axis, which one is the y-axis? Because if you are wrongly pick the axis, which is maybe you go for annual sale is x-axis and the square feet is the y-axis, you may get the different pattern of graph, which is maybe you will get the wrong question. So, does anyone have an idea how to ensure that the you are not picking up the wrong axis for your element of graph? Excel output. Okay, so square feet. So this one. So annual sales. This one. So this is the graph. This graph. In other words, let's say you have the greater square feet, so you have the greater annual sales, perhaps. So the idea is like this. Let's say you have the square feet 5,000. For let's say for G store. But suddenly your annual sale is somewhere over here, let's say 4,000, which is you are doing something wrong or obviously abnormal. Because what? Your colleague, the store number one until number seven, go for this kind of line accordingly by the trend of the bigger square feet, obtain the annual sales higher compared to your side. Let's say you are go for the 4,000 square feet, but yet you only manage to get 4,000 400,000 or 4,000 annual sales. Okay, so that's the how they try to interpret this kind of graph or this kind of output in terms of the to convince the management. Maybe you want to invest, maybe you want to close or to shut down the store and everything. So that is the one of the parameter or crucial part. So that's why we need to know concisely what happened or operational basis to our store so that we can defend, okay, to ensure that we can try to survive accordingly with the good sales. Okay. So another simple linear regression equation example. So why not? Why to be not B1 X1? So why is on this equation from the Excel printout? Intercept means that the intercept means that the C value. X variable, okay, 1.4, meaning that the M, the slope, 1.48. Okay, so this is how it's look like. Okay, so this is the graph. This is graph, linear regression, okay, simple linear regression equation. So by having this kind of graph, you can try to predict, let's say, what happened for your annual sale if you invest or the higher square feet, maybe 7,000, 8,000, or 10,000. So it should be somewhere increment some sort of like this part, which is give you a better revenue in term of the utilization. So this is the prediction. Let me see what happened here. What happened here? Yeah. So you need to careful on this. Yeah. So same goes as well. This one. Okay. So your sales somewhere you can predict roughly. Yet, as I mentioned just now, all relates to the data collection or data monitoring that have been obtained previously. So that's why the energy management is very crucial to have the collect collection of data so that you can analyze the data accordingly to justify your action or your recommendation or your investment in place according to the benefit of company. Okay. So the slope 1.8 is the increment of the 1x to predict average y increased by estimated 1.87. Okay, equation estimate for each increase for 1 square foot. Okay, expected and also are predicted to increase 1.87. Okay. So that's the conclusion based on the graph, based on this graph. Okay, guys, this is the exercise. So if you have your free time, then try to do this one. It's the set of data. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. Okay, 7. Okay, so try to do the linear equation for the data. Okay, as simple as that. And then the random sample of 8 driver, which showed the company have having a similar auto insurance policy was selected. The following table list, driving experience, okay, amount of the insurance premiums, okay. This based on the experience of driver. This one is the monthly auto insurance premium. Okay. So less experience, which is 2, considerably high. This one. Experience 25, highest. So your monthly auto insurance premium is only 42. Obtain the linear regression equation for both cases. Predict the monthly auto insurance for deliver with 10 years of driving experience. Okay. So by having this kind of information, try to predict with the 10 years of experience. Okay. So try to do later on for your exercises later. Okay. Exercise 3 as well. Measure hardware, store belief, okay. That there are linear relationship between the income sales for goods and the amount of spend advertising. Okay. So some of the manager claim that the more they advertise, the sale will increase. So this is the advertising cost. So this one is the income from sales. So try to do the linear regression for the case above. Predict the income from the sale of goods when 4,700 is spent on the advertising. Okay. So this is the one of the analysis can we conduct just to have the better understanding what we are going to predict or forecast for the future business. Okay, so we try to check another slide. Okay. Okay. Guys, this week is week what? Week 5, yeah. Week 5, so we need to complete this one. Oops, okay. Okay, guys, try to do this by your own exercise. Week 5. Okay, thank you already. So week 5, we have another 2 weeks left before we hand over the session to the PM. But I think we try to do this one accordingly. I mean, according to the schedule. Okay, so next is the correlation coefficient. It's the therefore important to determine how well the best fit correlation of the sample data. So normally they will denote as a r, small r, okay? Meaning that the it show the relationship, okay? the best fit correlates, okay? The best fit correlate. So the best fit correlate, okay? The higher the better. This value between 1 and 0, which a value representing 100% correlation, meaning that the close to the 1 is the better relationship or correlation coefficient. Okay, so this is the equation. Okay, it seems like same thing, like the x bar means the average of the x, okay, and y, and y bar, average of the y, or this equation. So you can go either the top or the bottom equation for the correlation coefficient. Okay, so sample, find the value correlation coefficient from the table, subject 165, 6, age, this one, glucose level, y. Okay, they try to see the correlation, the age with the glucose level. Okay, if we obtain the r close to the one, it shows the strong relationship or the coefficient. The age and the glucose have a strong relationship. Okay, if we manage to get the r maybe very small, maybe 0.1, maybe 1 or 2 or 3 or something. So we need that. There's no such thing. We try to relate age with the glucose level. Okay, so that's the thing. So before we go to analysis, can you guys predict by your experience or by your knowledge previously, what is the relationship between the ages and also the glucose level? What do you think before we go for the analysis? Zaidi, Nazmi, you want to try? What's your relationship? Have the relationship or not? Yeah. The more age, the more glucose level. Okay, we will see. So meaning that if Zaidi claim like that, meaning that our R value or coefficient or the performance ratio, it should be close to one. Okay, so we try to look at. Okay. Okay, so we try to see, and then we produce the x y and power of y 2 is equal to this thing, referring to the original equation. Sorry, this thing. This thing, referring to the. This equation, they try to set up this one, or this one. Okay, they will try to set up that one. So that's why they put this column. And yet they go for this one, 43 and 99, become this one, and go for this one. And yet the x power of 2 meaning that's the 43 times 43, and go for this one. And y power of 2, 99 power times 99, and we try to plug this one. Okay, so that after they complete this table, they go for the summation. Okay, sorry, for the summation as well. Okay, and then they insert the things in this equation R. Okay, with this information, and sample is 6 means that this 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. And then they go for the correlation coefficient 0.59. So R equals 0.52, sorry, 0.5298. So we would see that is not strong relationship. Okay, it's not, the correlation coefficient is not that strong. Is there but not that strong. Okay, so okay, Zaidi. So that is how we try to trigger how good the relationship between the ages and glucose level. Okay, by the okay. In fact, let's say we have another, maybe this one is n equal to 6, right? Sorry, equal to 6. Maybe if we have the n, maybe 100, maybe it will give us a different r value, right? So that's the thing, we need to have as much as we can go for the sample or the data so that we can go for the better analysis to obtain the more reliable result. Okay. Okay, Zadia. Okay. Okay, so this is the thing. So this one is what? Age and weight. So I think this is the question that try to see the correlation between the age and the weight, I think. So I think this is another exercise that we try to see. Okay, so most of our multivariable analysis, most of the time energy consumption is influenced by the several variable. Okay, so several variable means that it will fall to the varies of M. Maybe S1, S2, Sn variable that is why difficult to solve multi variable, impossible to use specialist computer software. Okay, so normally when we go for the more complicated analysis or multi variable, we go for the computer software to help us to determine any relationship into our statistical between the variable. So but then our task need to ensure we can understand and also be able to interpret what is the result will tell us, or else it's a very huge of waste because we spend expensive tools or software, but then we cannot do the or use it wisely by having a good interpretation by our knowledge or by the condition of the output result. Okay, so multivariable analysis, number of sample, minimum correlation coefficient. Okay, that's the thing. Okay, so that's it. So last but not least, okay, you guys have the connection problem. Okay, so far, okay, so far so good. Okay, so far so good. Eh?